we are completely aware about the current scenario of this pandemic. So we all know that if we are not dealing properly with the nature, that we can, then we can face such kind of pandemics. And even in history, we have seen that if we are going on destructing this nature, then we will face such kind of pandemics and some epidemics. So now it has came towards the such technology that we should make use of this nature's technology, so that we can make possible use of these solutions to treat the water, the waste we are generating, as well as to go towards the sustainable development of this system. So going towards the introduction, now according to WHO, it has estimated that around 1/3 of the world's population, they are not having the access to the clean drinking water. So that's why they are facing lots of problems. And nowadays we can see the water, the wastewater is generating in the globe is directly discharged into the environment, and that is very harmful. So which is causing lot more destruction to the environment as well as ecosystem. Now it is very essential to treat this wastewater before discharging into the into the ecosystem. So, and because of this, we are facing lots of problems, just like cholera, dysentery, and this such kind of disease where every year we are facing. And even we are water, the clean sources of water we are having, that is getting polluted due to the discharge of this untreated wastewater. So now we have to focus on this treatment of this wastewater, so that we can discharge it into the this ecosystem before better treated before discharging. And also we know that what are the treatment we are giving to this wastewater, that is having somewhat energy consumption, consuming, as well as expensive in nature. So we have to find out methodologies which can be economical, that will consume, or which will consume zero or very less energy, so that we can treat it in a very natural way and in very less expenses. And after treating it in a natural way, we can discharge into the nature itself. Okay, so that will be a sustainable way of treatment, and we can go towards a sustainable development by adopting this treatment system. Now, so regulations are very strict nowadays. We have to follow this regulation, because if we are not following, then we will definitely going to pollute our own sources of water, just like the rivers, lakes, all these sources which are having as a drinking water sources. That we will get, we will be polluting, and we will not get the clean and water for the drinking, as well as remaining other purpose of for the daily users. Now, in current scenario, economical crunch for the very developed countries are facing the problem for the this treatment system. As I have previously said, it takes very much expenses to treat the wastewater. So that we are putting lots of money into the treatment. So these are causing this economic crunch to the developed as well as developing nations. So what are the domestic wastewater and industrial wastewater they are there? They have to treat by the conventional system, and this conventional system are consuming much more energy as well as that expenses. So in case the technological treatment facilities are installed in many developing countries, and the energy input is difficult to be supplied in view of the global energy crisis, as the country like India, we are having the problems of electricity, just like in some regions, just especially in the rural area, we are facing the problem of electricity cut and all things. And in that, we are having the additional load of this treatment. We cannot sustain that much of electricity or that much of energy consumption for this treatment. So we have to find out this natural treatment solutions, so that we can reduce this load on this electricity consumption, and we can treat in a proper way. Okay. Then sustainable sanitation system requires this low cost and low energy consumption, as well as low mechanical technology. Because in this natural treatment, we are actually replicating the this natural whatever the natural system are there in the nature into some artificial way, so that what are the treatment system are there, they are having low or very less or no mechanical technology, just like a very very low moving part, or if we are working under the gravity, then we will not require the pumping system, will not require the strapping mechanism, so that what are the mechanical equipment, they will be completely skipped by this natural technology, and along with that we will require the this we will less require this maintenance of this treatment. Okay, so there are various better choices of this treatment which are very cost effective, especially for the rural areas. Nowadays we are also moving toward this in urban areas also for the treatment of this wastewater by using this natural treatment solution or nature based solution, NBS. So therefore a sustainable way of wastewater is essential for this case, so that we can go towards the sustainable development. Now there are some definitions for this nature based solutions. Then according to International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN, they defined this nature based solution in 2016, the actions to protect, sustainably manage and restore natural or modified ecosystem that addresses societal changes effectively and adaptively, simultaneously providing human well-being and biodiversity benefits. So what are the actions we are taking that will be towards the protection of the our water ecosystem is there, then we have to manage that ecosystem in a sustainable way, and also we have to restore the natural ecosystem. Okay, if we are not restoring the natural ecosystem, then we are nowadays seeing looking towards this what are the global problems we are facing if we are destructing this nature. Okay, so that will address the societal changes, especially for this human well-being and the benefits of this biodiversity. So this is the definition given by IUCN. Then according to European Commission, they have defined it as a living solutions inspired by, continuously supported by, and using nature. So what are the nature itself having that we have to use, we have to take inspiration from this nature for the treatment of this wastewater, which are designed to address various societal changes in resource efficient and acceptable manner, and to provide simultaneously this economical, social, and environmental benefits. So what are this natural based solutions are there that will be providing us the economical as well as social and environmental benefits. So economical, in case of we are reducing the cost of treatment, we are improving the social life of this people by providing this sustainable solution, and this is beneficial mostly for the environmental benefit, because they are not discharging the waste into the directly not discharging into the environment, and we are keeping this sustainable solutions for the treatment. Okay, now now we can see that we have in history also we have seen whatever the this research or whatever the that the what are that requirements we are having, we have taken this inspiration from the nature. Just like if you have seen the aeroplane, so that we have aeroplane, we have taken this inspiration from the birds, how they are flying into the this atmosphere, how they are roaming from one place to another place. So similarly, we are taking this inspiration for the wastewater treatment from the nature itself. What are the plants, what are the soil, what are the filter media there, we are taking this inspiration from the nature itself, so that we can give a better and a sustainable treatment solution for the wastewater treatment. Next, what are the nature based techniques? They are mimics of the natural processes in urban landscape, including wastewater management with low inputs of energy and chemicals. Also, the chemicals required for this treatment are very low, or sometimes zero chemicals we are using, depending upon the inlet of the wastewater, what are the influent are there. Okay, again, this NBS, they are contributing to saving the energy by reducing the cooling loads, reduce flooding risk and promote a sustainable economic growth. So wherever, just like mangroves are there, they are especially on the coastal area, whatever the this nature-based solution we have provided, they are reducing the risk of this floods in that area. So every year we can see in the northeast region, just like Assam, Guwahati, especially in this West Bengal where I am living, for 100 kilometers from this, it is a coastal region. So they are facing every year the this flooding problem. Assam, Odisha, so they are facing the problem, and that problem can be much more reduced by using this nature-based solutions. So that will save lots of lives every year. That will save lots of money of the country, that economy of the country. Okay, so they are very good solution for this contributing and developing our nation. Okay. Then previous studies, they have demonstrated that the positive effects induced by greening vacant urban land on the well-being of the people. What are the you can see in your region also, what are the vacant spaces are there? If you are greening those vacant spaces, then we can make it as a aesthetic view, as well as it will reduce the what are the temperature increase in the atmosphere of the this nature, that will be reduced by this greening of this vacant urban spaces. Okay. Then this solutions significantly support biodiversity by providing habitats for different species. Whatever the species are getting diminished by the entry of the humans into the this forest area, cutting down the forest area. So this is harmful because we are directly reducing the very species, and they are part of the ecosystem. We are actually harming the ecosystem. So whatever the nature-based system are there, they are helping and supporting the supporting for the biodiversity increment, and also providing the habitats for the various species. Okay, so that will be the very beneficial for the ecosystem, which are providing this home to this different flora and fauna of the environment. Now, so what are the nature-based solutions for the wastewater treatment? They are using the modified natural self-treatment processes that take place in the ground soil, water, and wetland environment. So whatever the wastewater, whatever the technology is present in the nature itself, we are somewhat making a modification so that we can call it the artificial or the human-made treatment processes, so that we can have a good kind of result for the treatment of this wastewater. Okay, so these solutions classified according to various treatment technology, as well as the what the arrangement we are providing. So first one is here soil ground filters. So they are having types, that is vertical flow without vegetation and horizontal flow without vegetation. So here is our sound ground filters, soil ground filters. We are providing this solution without vegetation. So what are the possibilities of the using this facilities? That is treatment of storm water and sewage of smaller and middle producer. What are the storm waters are there that can be treated, and what are the pollutants are there in the storm water that can be reduced, and the water sewage from the smaller and middle producers or small community that can be treated by using this soil filters. Then next is the constructed wetland treatment. So there are different types, just like horizontal surface, combination of surface and horizontal subsurface flow, then horizontal subsurface flow, vertical flow. What is the, if it is downward vertical, then it will be downward vertical flow, then upflow treatment, then vertical with intermittent flow. So these are the various types of this constructed wetland treatment. And what are the uses are, they are used for the wastewater as well as contaminated surface water treatment. Then sewage treatment, then it can be used for the year-round operation. No, that is what are the type of climate, it will not be affected by this. Then wastewater treatment, predominantly in the summer for this, so vertical flow, especially summer season. And sewage treatment, it is also vertical flow with intermittent flow, that can be used year-round operation. Next is the waste stabilization pond. So they are having different types, just like aerobic low loaded, aerobic high loaded, then aerobic continuously with aeration, then for the final purification. Just like if you are having high load of wastewater, then we are treating it with some conventional method, And to reduce the low load or the some as a tertiary treatment, we can use it for this final purification, this waste stabilization point. Then anaerobic and anaerobic storage. So these are the uses of this. So surface runoff and waste water treatment in climatic favorable areas. Then intensive wastewater treatment, continuous aeration. Then final treatment of wastewater after biological treatment. So here I have already told that if we are having the high load, then we can provide it as a final treatment or just like a polishing of the wastewater as a polishing pond. Then anaerobic treatment, which is pre-ranked anaerobic aerobic treatment. Then wastewater treatment of the campaign producer. Then next one is the aquatic plant system and bioeliminators. So pond and aquatic plant system, one of the type of that. Then combination of aquacultures with aquatic plant system, then bioeliminators. So these are used for the wastewater treatment and treatment by means of duckweeds, algae, cyanobacteria. These are the main part of this treatment. Then municipal and industrial wastewater treatment can be done by this using combination of aquaculture as well as aquatic plant system. Then wastewater treatment tanks with submerged meshes for algae biomass attaching. Okay, so by using these bioelementers, we can treat this wastewater. Then next one is irrigation by wastewater. So here we require minimally mechanical treated wastewater. We can provide it for the irrigation. So irrigation by municipal wastewater, then by industrial, then by agriculture, by liquid sludge and slurry, and evapotranspiration system with zero discharge. Okay. So these are used for the growing season in irrigation or annual irrigation, then growing season operation for non-growing season irrigation, vegetation irrigation by sillage and processed wastewater, then utilization of fertilizing effect of liquid waste, vegetation usually willow or irrigation in vegetation irrigation controlled bed by municipal wastewater. So these are the various types of this nature-based solution for wastewater. So in the case of use of natural methods for wastewater treatment, it is necessary to pay special attention to the process of pre-treatment. So because if we are directly applying or providing wastewater for the treatment through this nature-based solution, it will bring the failure of this system, nature-based treatment system. So we have to provide some pre-treatment, just like screening, then removal of some suspended particles or some grids, because if we are not removing the suspended solids or this grids from this wastewater, that will clog this nature-based solution treatment, and it will fail that treatment system in the initial phase itself. Okay, so we have to take a special attention toward this process of pre-treatment. Okay, so what are the sufficient dimensions of this device, just like screens, sand traps, grid traps, biological septic tanks, and that we have to take care of this sufficient dimension, so that water, the wastewater is coming, that should not be bypassed or over flooded and directly come into this nature-based solution treatment. And hereafter I will call nature-based solution as an NBS. So this NBS will be get again failed if you are not providing the proper dimension. That means we have to design this devices before installing. So proper design is very important. Then we have to ensure sufficient retention time. Okay, so we have to provide sufficient retention time of this devices, as well as we have to maintain the proper flow rate. So if we are it is associated with the combined sewer, just like if storm water is coming entering into this system, then we have to take care of this flow rates of the wastewater entering into our NBS system. And it should be it is a very simple operation of that is NBS. Okay, and appropriate sludge and waste management should be proper there. What are the sludges coming into this pre-treatment devices, that should be maintained or managed. If it is if we are to regularly desludge these devices time by time, okay, to have a good effect of this treatment. Again, what are the access of this different part should be very proper, so that we can maintain it in a regular basis. Okay, so we have to provide the proper access. Again, we have to provide the desludging outlet, so that we can desludge it in a proper way and in proper duration. So next we have come towards our first NBS system, that is the constructed wetland treatment. So here you can see this is the constructed wetland treatment plant, very small size. You can only see the vegetation over, because generally water, the filter bed are there, they are underground, and you can see only the vegetations. So it gives a very aesthetic view, and you can if somebody is there, if he is not having any idea about this treatment plant or treatment unit, so he might be think that it is just a very just like a garden or some good landscape is there. But it is not only garden or landscape, it is a treatment unit. It will treat your wastewater. Even also in various part of India, we are using this treatment unit. In Niri is there, again Nagpur University, then IIT Bombay we are having, then Municipal Corporation of Kolhapur, they are using this for some small slums where the access where the wastewater is directly discharging into the ecosystem. This is Kolhapur Municipal Corporation, they are using this treatment technology to treat the wastewater, and because of that they have found that in previous few years after installing this treatment technology, that whatever the diseases which are spreading through the this improper sanitation, they have been reduced drastically into that area. So that is a good example given by this Municipal Corporation of Kolhapur. So this constructed wetland, they are nature based treatment, because we are replicating this constructed wetland from inspiring from the nature. And they are the filtration system planted with wetland vegetation. As in previous figure, we are seeing the vegetations over there. These vegetations, we are using the reed plants, then reed canary grass and a cattle as well, which are the mostly used this vegetations, which will provide the good efficiency for the treatment of wastewater, because vegetation is a very important part of this constructed wetland. So because of that, we can get a good kind of removal of the nutrients, then organic matter, as well as the solid that suspended solids which is coming into the wastewater. Okay, this basic principle of this method is the flow of wastewater through a filtration system which is planted with the wetland vegetation. So depending upon the flow, there are various types of constructed wetland. I will not going into this in this detail of this constructed wetland, various different types of the wetland. So in general, they are having horizontal flow, vertical flow, then again tidal flow wetland are there. So depending upon the direction of flow, they are differentiated. And what are the filter meters we are providing, that should be permeable enough to avoid clogging. So this is the most important criteria. We have to look after the filter bed. It should not get clogged in a short duration. So we have to maintain this inlet sludge into this treatment unit, so that it will not get clogged in a short duration. Then when the wastewater passes through the material, the treatment occurs carried out by the complex intermingling of chemical, physical and biological process. Actually, this process of the treatment through this constructed wetland is a very complex treatment, because it is involving the physical, chemical and biological process. Just like physical, in we are settling down or removing this solid particles. Again, chemicals, what are the chemicals are entering, just like nutrients are entering, nitrogen, phosphorus, that will get removed. And biological process, what are the root systems of this plant vegetation, they are having the this rhizome, they are having the bacteria or microorganism present on that, that will help to decompose the organic matter from complex to simpler one, so that it can be easily treated and removed from this wastewater. So that's why it is called a very complex system, which is having getting involved in this chemical, physical and biological processes. Okay. So here you can see the view of this constructed wetland. It is a horizontal flow wetland. So here are the vegetations, and this is a filter bed here. So this is number one is the inlet of this unit, and here you can see this eighth one is the inspection shaft, and ninth one is the regulation pipe. What are the flow and what are the depth of the wastewater into this filter bed can be regulated by using this regulation pipe. Yes. यस आदित्य,
अतुल तू कैमरा बंद कर तू का तुझा, हाँ कैमरा बंद कर तू का, वॉइस ब्रेक होता है। हाँ
एक
हाँ
मिनट,
वॉइस ब्रेक होता है तुझा, स्पीड कम ही नहीं होता।
इज इट फाइन?
हाँ ठीक है ठीक।
ओके, तो दिस इज द सेक्शनल थ्रू व्यू ऑफ दिस हॉरिजॉन्टल फ्लो कंस्ट्रक्टेड वेटलैंड. द व्हाट आर द वेस्ट वाटर फ्लोइंग इन अ डायरेक्शन, इफ इट इज अ हॉरिजॉन्टल फ्लो देन इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज हॉरिजॉन्टल फ्लो कंस्ट्रक्टेड वेटलैंड, एंड इफ द डायरेक्शन इज वर्टिकल फ्लो देन इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज अ वर्टिकल फ्लो कंस्ट्रक्टेड वेटलैंड वेट. सो हियर यू कैन सी द साइड व्यू ऑफ वर्टिकल फ्लो फिल्टर बेड. सो यू कैन सी हियर द दिस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन पाइप्स आर देयर व्हिच आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग द वेस्ट वाटर इन अ वर्टिकल मैनर. सो इट इज एक्चुअली इट इज अ डाउनवर्ड फ्लो वर्टिकल फ्लो कंस्ट्रक्टेड वेटलैंड. वेरियस यूनिट्स आर देयर जस्ट लाइक इन फ्लो पाइप, देन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन पाइप, ओके, देन कलेक्शन सिस्टम इज देयर, ओके, एंड फाइनली यू हैव टू टेक द आउटफ्लो फ्रॉम दिस कलेक्शन यूनिट. तो कंस्ट्रक्टेड वेटलैंड इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज रिड बेड्स बिकॉज रिड बेड्स दिस इज द वेजिटेशन एंड दीज आर द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस कंस्ट्रक्टेड वेटलैंड. सो दैट्स वाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज कंस्ट्रक्टेड रिड बेड ऑल्सो, विच रिप्रेजेंट द बायोलॉजिकल ट्रीटमेंट स्टेज. एक्चुअली इट इज यूज एज अ सेकेंडरी और टर्शियरी ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द वेस्ट वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट बिकॉज वी कैन नॉट डायरेक्टली यूज इट एज अ प्राइमरी ट्रीटमेंट बिकॉज इट विल डायरेक्टली गेट फेल्ड इफ यू आर प्रोवाइडिंग द using it as a primary treatment because water, the sludge or these grit particles are coming and even high load of organic matter and nutrients are there that will not be get sustained by this treatment constructive wetland. So we have to provide this pre-treatment for this wastewater before it is introducing it to the constructive wetland. So it is based on the slow filtration of the pre-treated wastewater. So we have to provide the pre-treated wastewater into the system, and it is some kind of slow process but very effective process as a best solution for the wastewater treatment. So it may also be used as for a tertiary treatment from effluent from mechanical biological treatment plant, so as well as tertiary treatment. These are constructed as watertight beds filled with a filter material and planted with locally relevant or ornamental wetland vegetation. So one of the best importance or advantage of this system is that we can use the locally available material, what are the filter materials are there, and what are the locally available ornamental plants, just like typha is there, then Canna indica, ज्याला आपण मराठी मध्ये कर्दळी म्हणतो, Canna indica. That can be used as a wetland vegetation in this that the kardari manto apan, that kardari or the Canna indica, that is very very effective in the treatment of the wastewater, and the research has proved that this Canna indica is very good vegetation for this use in the for their use in the constructed wetland. Okay, so what are the advantages? Now coming to the advantage of this constructed wetland. So first one is aesthetic integration. Just as in previous slide we have seen that they are ornamental, just like that kardali. Apan je kardali mhanta, like chhan ache flowers hetat, we can see that flowers. Okay, so they are very good giving the aesthetic view to the human beings, and they are very also giving the very good treatment efficiency. Okay. So they are giving the aesthetic integration into the environment, and it increases the biodiversity of the landscape by creating the artificial wetland. Okay. And they favorably affect the microclimate in the immediate vicinity due to the relatively significant evaporation of water by vegetation. So it is giving the good if effect of the microclimate because of this evaporation of the water, because vegetation helps in the evaporation of this water into the atmosphere. It is because it is a part of your water cycle and your ecosystem, so that will give the good their contribution in the ecosystem. So very energy saving treatment system because we are not requiring the any kind of energy or electricity here, even not even the any mechanical part we require. So it can be a very good energy saving option for the treatment. Then operation cost is very low because maintenance is very low because we are using the locally available material. Then plants which are already present into the ecosystem, we can use it as a treatment unit. So because of that, the treatment cost is getting reduced by this treatment constructed wetland. Okay. Again, the construction is very simple. We don't require any kind of skilled labors to construction of this unit. Again, it is possible to construct in on the self-help basis. So no, it is not require any kind of engineering knowledge or taking any research base for the construction of this. You can directly put your filter material, and you will directly, you have to plant this vegetation, and it will be ready to use. Okay. So because of that, very less human resources and machinery of this machineries will be required for the implementation of this waste constructed wetland. Now the proper design can achieve high treatment effects. So in previous advantage, we have seen that it can be constructed without any engineering knowledge. But if you are having your knowledge, proper engineer and research knowledge, you can achieve the higher treatment efficiency for the treatment of this wastewater. Just like what are the organic load is there, what are the nutrient load is there, that can be reduced drastically by if you are having the good knowledge of this constructed wetland. Okay. Again, pulse emptying or filling of filter may sufficiently provide oxygen saturation of the environment and removal of ammonia and nitrogen. So this proper oxygen supply into this treatment unit helps in the nitrification and denitrification process, which will help to remove of the ammonia and nitrogen to the much more extent. So that is one of the advantage of this constructed wetland system. And also especially it has been seen that in horizontal, in case of horizontal, there is less removal of this ammonia, but in case of vertical flow, it has been removed more amount of ammonia. So that's why if we are concentrating on the ammonia or nitrogen removal, we have to go towards the vertical flow constructed wetland. So here comes our engineering or research knowledge, so that if we are having that knowledge, then we can focus specially on that particular parameters for the removing through the wastewater. So the removal of ammonia and nitrogen is sufficient even during the implementation of constructed wetland filter with vertical flow. So as I previously said, so vertical flow is a very good option. And continuously washing filters permanently filled with water with the anaerobic environment may serve to denitrification of wastewater, and which will help in the removal of nitrate nitrogen. So this anaerobic environment, that will help in the removal of nitrate nitrogen. So every treatment or every system, along with advantages, it comes with the disadvantages also. First one, when used as the main treatment stages, just like primary, or if there is high surface demand, just like having the much more organic load. So depending upon the design, from 2 to 5 meters square per capita equivalent in case of the request for removal of insoluble substances, then ammonia, organic and bacterial pollution. So it requires that much amount of land or that surface area to remove of this this waste from the wastewater. Again, in the basic configuration, the filters with continuous horizontal flow permanently filled with water has the low effectiveness in removing ammonia nitrogen. So in case of horizontal, we are having the less removal efficiency of the nitrogen, ammonia nitrogen. Then stable removal of phosphorus from water is only possible by using special filter materials with elevated sorption capacity limited to potential phosphorus removal. So if you are facing on the phosphorus removal, we have to focus on the special filter materials. If they are not available, then we cannot remove phosphorus to the certain amount. So that is one of the disadvantages if we are focusing on the phosphorus removal. If you are focusing on the phosphorus removal by this constructed wetland, you have to use special type of filter materials which can absorb the this phosphorus on the surface of this filter material. Then the risk of clogging, that is a very important mainly focusing this disadvantage of the every constructed wetland wherever they have been implemented. Most of the that beneficiaries are facing this problem of the clogging. What are the solid contents are coming? They are clogging the filter bed of the this constructed wetland unit. So because of that this clogging issue, we have to focus on this pre-treatment of the this wastewater. Okay, so that is one of the reason very having the very greater concern for this implementation of this constructed wetland. Now removing taking focus on the removal efficiency of the constructed wetland treatments, they are primarily physical process of the filtration and sedimentation remove suspended solid and organic compounds which are present that can be removed by microbial, aerobic and anaerobic activities, and the colloidal particles can be removed from the wastewater by filtration, sedimentation and adsorption. So by various processes we are removing the various parameters, not only by only one process. As we have already discussed, it is a complex treatment system, so it is taking advantage of this physical, chemical as well as biological processes to remove the various parameters. Okay, again to some degree there is a removal of nitrogen in the process of ammonification, nitrification and denitrification, so that is very helpful for the removal of nitrogen. Then phosphorus is removed by adsorbing that phosphorus onto the filter metal and trapped sedimentation by wetland vegetation biomass sampling. Whatever the phosphorus coming, that is get trapped over the sediments or the filter particle, and that will be adsorbed by the wetland vegetation for the personal growth, and that is get accumulated into the biomass of that vegetation. Then various research has been carried out for this and they have found out the removal efficiency of these parameters. So these various researchers, they have concluded the research, they have conducted the research and concluded this average removal efficiency of the various parameters. So BOD, 5-day BOD has found the removal efficiency of 85%, then COD of 75%, suspended solid of 80%, then NH4 and ammonia nitrogen around 30%, total phosphorus around 35%. So this was a removal efficiency they have achieved. Again, various research are again getting carried out for increasing the removal efficiency of these various parameters. So the again some researchers, they have compared the treatment efficiency of the vertical flow and horizontal surface flow constructive wetland to find out the effect of this different types of filter constructive wetland filters in different regions, because it also get affected by the climatic conditions, and they have found out that the COD removal was high in Germany in vertical flow. Okay, so this is the 68 the mg per liter of out COD in outlet after treatment. So sorry, in Austria it was higher removal in vertical flow, and for NH4N it was higher in Austria also, again in vertical flow. Okay, for ammonia NO3N it was higher in horizontal surface flow in Germany, which was 7 mg per liter in the outlet, and total nitrogen, so data of the Germany is only available, not of Austria. So it was good in horizontal surface flow, and total phosphorus was in vertical flow in Germany. So this was a comparison of this two different flow directional flow wastewater constructed wetland filters. So what are the vegetation, that is the important part, what is the role of this vegetation in this constructed wetland? So first one, it influences the treatment process. Because of this wetland vegetation, they are enhancing or they are increasing the removal efficiency of the wastewater by decomposing that complex matter to simple one and absorbing the that nutrients for their personal growth. Then protection and stabilization of the surface of the filter material. What are the surface of the filter material there? That will not be get eroded out. That will be remain as a stabilized, in a stabilized way. Okay. Then formation of suitable environment for organisms present in the filter material. What are the microorganisms or the bacteria which are good for the treatment of this wastewater, which are helping to break down of the complex metal to the simpler one? They are getting formed because of the presence of this vegetation, and they are helping into the removal of these various pollutant parameters, pollution causing parameters. Then they are also protecting against the clogging of the filter metal because of whatever sludge are coming, whatever organic matter are coming, they are clogging the filter bed and they are getting decomposed and they are getting removed some up to certain extent by this wetland vegetation. Then oxygen supply to the area close to the roots are supplied by these roots. Okay, what are the roots are there near to roots? They are what are the oxygen present in the atmosphere that is get absorbed by the plants or that leaves of that plants and that is get released near to the root zone of the this vegetation. So because of that, they are providing the aerobic and some anoxic zones into the vicinity of that root zone area. So that will help helping to maintain the aerobic and anoxic zone near to that root zone. Okay. So it also enhance aesthetic effect and allow positive integration into the landscape. So it provide very good look and good view for the that if we are providing in some open spaces. So that will give a good and aesthetic view. Again, it will help in maintaining the flora and fauna and the habitat of the nature. So nutrient depletion and vice versa supply of the carbon from decomposing organic residue. What are the organic residues are there that will be decomposed and again that will help into the if nutrition nutrient depletion is there that will be get increased by this biomass. Okay, then it will absorb and accumulate the range of micro and macro elements including nutrients, heavy metals. So they will it will be also research has suggested proved that whatever the heavy metals are coming into the wastewater that can be absorbed by this vegetations for their personal growth, just like some iron is there, some arsenic or some just like this that heavy metals which are very toxic in nature that will be absorbed by this vegetations. Okay, then stabilization and thermal insulation of filter metal in the winter. So if just like in winter we can see the temperature decreases, so because of that as the temperature decreases the treatment efficiency of filter get reduced, but because of this vegetation it helps to maintain the proper temperature so that it can have a stable temperature and it will provide as a thermal insulator of that filter bed. And most widely using plants are there. There are phragmatics, australis, then reed, sweet grass. This is called Glycivia maxima. Then reed canary grass. Then Phalaris arundica, cattles. That is Typha latifolia and Typha angustifolia. Then sedex. So these are the various and mostly used wetland plants into this constructed wetland. Okay. So next one is the next type is soil filters. So here you can see it is the soil and that sand particles are used for the treatment of the wastewater. Only the small cover of the grass is provided, so which is just for the aesthetic view of the this soil filter and some to help to not get eroded out because of the flow of the water. Okay, so like other devices they can be divided into the filters with vertical and horizontal as well as radial flow, but soil filters are without vegetations often realized in underground. Okay, so there are also different types, vertical, horizontal and radial flow. So what are the terrain only revision pipes are seen that protrude from the grass or another terrain finish. So here you can see only pipes because it is completely underground, so you cannot see the whole filter bed by general visual observation. It as it is underground, it is necessary to ensure that the flow of treated wastewater is uniform through the whole process. So here in this filters you have to take care about the uniform flow through the filter through the whole filter process. So depending upon the treated wastewater, the depth of filtration layers varies. So water here you can see the depth of filter bed, it varies upon the type of wastewater and the water the pollution load of the wastewater. Okay, ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ वेस्ट सरफेस वाटर प्रेसिपिटेशन फ्रॉम रूफ्स एंड कार पार्क्स. सो फॉर दैट केस वी हैव टू प्रोवाइड द थिकनेस ऑफ 0.6 टू 0.8 मीटर विच आर द वेरी शैलो फिल्टर्स. फॉर स्मॉल प्रोड्यूसर्स वी कैन प्रोवाइड द मिनिमम डीप फिल्टर्स विद डेप्थ ऑफ 0.8 टू 1.6 मीटर एंड द डेप्थ ऑफ 0.8 टू 1.2 मीटर दैट कैन बी प्रोवाइड एज अ सेकंड स्टेज बायोलॉजिकल ट्रीटमेंट. And if it is as a first stage biological treatment unit, then we have to provide the deep layer filters with a thickness at least of 1.6 meter. So which can also go up to 2.4 meter. So that is the depth we have to provide the soil filters. Okay. So here you can see. So what are the types of soil filters according to the filling and the use? What are the load is coming and treatment effect? So if we are having this light loamy soil, then the load in meter, that is here you can see, and treatment efficiency for this is removing around 95% of BOD and 90% of suspended solid. You can fine grain sand of size 1 to 2 mm, so they are reducing that much amount of BOD. So here you can see as the size of the sand or that filter particle is increasing, this removal efficiency is also reducing. So here at the beginning it is very high removal efficiency, and as we go increasing the size of the sand, removal efficiency also reduces. But the problem is that the size, as the size of filter particle is reduced less, then it will having the problem of clogging. So we have to keep watch on that part also, so that we can have the maximum removal efficiency with lower clogging effect of this because of this solid particles coming into the soil filter. So that is the important part. Then the treatment efficiency of we have already covered. Then so COD researcher, they have applied this COD of the 480 mg per liter, BOD of 219 mg per liter suspended. So they have found that this is a research based. And they have found that the removal of COD was 82%, BOD of 90%, suspension of 83%. That was a very good removal efficiency by their research. And in case the ammonia nitrogen, if suppose there is a nitrogen is there, ammonia nitrogen, the removal efficiency they have found about 39%, and concentration was around 33 mg per liter. What is the phosphorus removal efficiency was quite high as compared to the ammonia nitrogen, was around 47%, and for the inlet concentration of 6.3 mg per liter. Okay. So then coming to the advantages of the soil filters, so they are very energy saving treatment elements and functions without electricity supply, no electricity is required, and because the energy is very much saved by this process. Low operation costs, low demands on operation. As there are no moving parts, no mechanical equipment, the operation cost is very, very low. And whatever the demands for the operation or the maintenance, that is very low in this case. Then, if we are designing it in a proper way, we can achieve a high amount of treatment efficiency. So that is again coming to the part of your engineering knowledge and research knowledge. If you want to achieve the high removal efficiency by using this soil filters. So again, soil filters which flow in unsaturated filter environment, that is non-flooded, are suitable for the removal of ammonia pollution because it is inducing some oxygen. Because of that, you can find out the much more amount of ammonia removal because of the unsaturated environment in the soil filters. So when there is a convenient arrangement, it is possible to backwash filters. So here, if suppose in some cases we can find out the clogging has been increased in the filter bed, so you can provide the possible arrangement of backwashing so that you can use it for the longer duration. And also, what are the backwashing is there, you have to take care that what are the filter material is there that should not be extracted or extruded from this backwashing process. Okay, so disadvantages. So when used as a main treatment stage, then you have to provide high surface area up to 5 m². Okay, if you are using as a main treatment stage, then the risk of clogging is high. If you are not providing the pre-treatment to the wastewater, that is the main param main which is the biggest disadvantage of this nature based system. Okay, then for covered soil filters, it is difficult to control the state of filtration environment and process of filtration. Suppose if it is covered by the soil, then you have, if you have to maintain, or you have to maintain for the, especially in case of clogging, you have to it becomes very difficult to control that part. Then soil filters with a saturated filtration environment, just like the flooded environment, so in that case removal of ammonia is very less. So because it is not providing some oxygen for their removal, so that's why ammonia removal is very less in that case. Then here you can see the sectional view of these soil filters. So it is a vertical flow soil filter. Various arrangements are there: inlet pipe and collecting units. Then drain control shaft is there. Then this is the vertical flow in saturated filtration environment. Then this vertical flow upward. Here it is the upward flow direction in the saturated filter environment. Okay. Next part is, next type of our NBS is wastewater stabilization pond. Okay. So stabilization pond, they are important part of natural treatment, and they have been having the good treatment effect by the complex treatment system of this physical involving of the physical, chemical, and biological processes. Water occurring in the aquatic environment, just like our wetland. Okay. Here you can see the wastewater stabilization pond cross section area. So, if depth is very high, then around 2 to 5 meters, then it will be anaerobic. If 1 to 2.5 meter, then it will be a facultative. And if it is 0.5 to 1 meter depth, it will be anaerobic stabilization pond. So they are categorizing, especially in this fit, three categories: aerobic, facultative, and anaerobic. Okay, so the aerobic, you can provide the low load, high load, continuous aerator, and final treatment as a treatment unit. So if you are low loaded, then polluted wastewater treatment in the climate of Central Europe, just like if you are having the very high pollution load, then temperature, you have to think about the climate also. Okay, then high loaded, this for South Europe, they have been implemented. And if you are using continuously aerated, so you can use the intensive municipal wastewater treatment. And final treatment is just as a that polishing treatment unit, you can use that as a final treatment, because for that you have to provide the good and proper pre-treatment of the wastewater. Then facultative gas and temporary points of inflow, form of transition of anaerobic and aerobic process of in one point. Okay, because generally they are facultative used as a connecting of this aerobic to the anaerobic point if they are in a series. Okay, then this anaerobic, they are anaerobic treatment of the wastewater if you require some removal of the sludge and some various parameter which are only reduced by this anaerobic environment. For that purpose, it can be used. Then prolonged sedimentation of municipal wastewater and industrial wastewater. Again, the wastewater treatment of the this industry, just like sugar mills, starch plants, etc. So these are the various types of this anaerobic and this stabilization pond. Then what are the advantages of this stabilization pond? So they are environmentally friendly treatment of pre-treated wastewater using natural methods which are taking place in the aquatic environment. Also, it requires very less energy demand, significantly lower operational cost for combine for the comparable investment cost with artificial machinery treatment. Relatively rapid incorporation, the possibility of short-term and long-term operation shutdown, resistant to short-term hydraulic and pollution overloads. Again, comparable pollution removal efficiency treatment will affect with the conventional method for wastewater treatment, high efficiency removal of bacteria contamination. What are the removal efficiencies there is high, and the bacterial contamination is also high in case of this stabilization pond. So the use as a third stage treatment, it is used as a third stage treatment because you have to provide the, some pre-treatment, primary and secondary, then you can use as a third treatment for the sewage. Then Convenient combination with the other natural treatment methods and final wastewater treatment, especially by means of irrigation by clean wastewater or aquaculture. And it is beneficial integration into the environment and natural landscape. Okay, so these are the various advantages. So disadvantages, it requires high surface area. Okay, if you have to implement onto this for treatment, then you will require the much more surface area. So if we are having some infertile or some economically unusable land, then it will not be a drawback. Okay, it will be advantageous because you are using such a land which is infertile. We are not using for any kind of agriculture purpose, or if it is very having low cost, then it will not be a disadvantage. Then slightly lower pollution removal treatment effects in winter. Suppose temperature is dropped in winter, then removal efficiency or the removal of pollutant load is very less because of this decrease in the temperature. Because in that case, we have to provide some artificial aeration. So that will be some higher costing of this treatment facility. Then the necessity of the sludging process of tanks is significantly lower by quality mechanical pretreatment. So if there is we have to necessity of providing this mechanical pretreatment for the sludging of this wastewater which is having the high sludge. If don't harvested sediments or biomass, odor may occur due to the biological breakdown. Especially in case of anaerobic ponds, if you are not properly harvesting the sediments or biomass, so because of this anaerobic treatment, odor will be released from this treatment biological breakdown, which will be a troublesome environment for the nearby residential area. So this is the disadvantage of this stabilization pond. Here you can see the aerobic pond. So this is the arrangement of an aerobic pond. Then here you can see one graphical representation of this aerobic pond. Then first we'll look after the aerobic ponds. So with prevailing oxygen regime belong to one of the most widely used technology. So here because of low depth, it can act as aerobic pond. And the resulting effect of the treatment of the pond depending upon the technology of the treatment. So especially on the quantity, physical and chemical, biological composition of the inflow wastewater. So we have to look after the influent parameters of the wastewater, physical, chemical and biological. And depending upon the inflow parameters, the removal efficiency will be depend. Okay, so the parameters just like the temperature, then length of filter area, then hydraulic retention time, then number of ponds in the series, then climatic conditions, then especially temperature, precipitation, and the direction and strength of wind, because direction and strength of wind will be very effective to keep the aerobic environment in this pond. The number of frosty and icy days, suppose in some very cold region areas, if frosty and icy days are very high, suppose much more duration are just like in Canada. You can see most of the months are icy and frosty. You cannot give the good treatment or high removal efficiency in that region. Okay. Again, the degree of wastewater dilution. If you are diluting the wastewater for the treatment, that is also important parameter, and surface water inflow. So these are the various parameters you have to look after to achieve the higher removal efficiency from this aerobic pond. Then the sources of oxygen aerobic ponds provide inflow surface water, partially wastewater, and the transfer of atmospheric oxygen from the atmosphere in contact with the water level. Okay, so because of that it is becoming aerobic because of this oxygen which is getting mixed at the surface of the water level. Then the main producer of the oxygen are algae and other green water plants during the photosynthesis in the vegetation period. So if the algae growth is there, they are helping to achieve higher removal efficiency because of by releasing the oxygen into the water. So the algae is the main producer of the oxygen in this pond. And the treatment effect reaches to 96-99%. This has been researched by this author, and they have found that the treatment effects are around 96-99%. So next part, next one is the continuously aerated pond. So these are here you can see one mechanical equipment is fixed here to aerate the pond to provide the artificial aeration. So they are the solution which is applied in the areas where there is a lack of adequate and cheap land. Suppose we are not having the cheap land, then we have to reduce the size of this pond, and as the size is reduced, surface area is reduced, depth is increased. So in case of increased depth, we have to provide the artificial aeration. Okay, so this artificial aeration we are providing with the help of some turbine or ejector systems, aerator, and to maintain the aerobic condition of this treatment pond. So the proposed retention time is 5 or more days. So what are the retention time for the wastewater here in this continuous aerated pond is 5 to at least 5 days. Okay, and the specific area per one population equivalent is around 2 to 3 meters square, and the depth should be around 1.2 to 2.4 meters. So that is some technical specification for the designing of this continuous aerated pond. Then next part, next one is the anaerobic pond. So the anaerobic pond treatment process takes place under anaerobic condition, so in absence of oxygen, and they are divided into three different categories. First one is the flow, sedimentation, and anaerobic storage ponds. So first one is the flow anaerobic pond. They are mostly prepended before the system of aerobic pond. So they are provided before the aerobic pond. Okay, the required retention time of water is from 2 to 5 days. So here the retention time of water is from 2 to 5 days in this anaerobic pond, and they are having the ability to disturb the complex binding of organic compound and water the substance subsequently facilitate ongoing aerobic processes. Okay, so next in type of this anaerobic pond is the sedimentation ponds. They are also pretended before the aerobic pond. Okay, if they are in the series, they are used for capturing the most settleable substrate. Okay, so what are the purpose of this pond is only to settle the water, the solids or the some grit particles are coming. So that is a very important parameter, because it will help into the reduction of pollution load. Okay, then sludge ponds space must be easily drainable and mineable. Okay, so what are the sludge ponds are there? You have to make proper arrangement so that water, the drainage system and the sludge removal system should be proper. And there are two proposed of rectangular ground shape. The ratio of width to length is around 1:5, and depth is around 1.2 to 2.5 meter, including the sludge area. So this depth is including the sludge area. The volume of sludge area is around 20 to 25% of total. Okay, so what are the volume of this anaerobic pond is there? That should have volume of 20 to 25% for the sludge accumulation, and the water retention time in this period is 1 to 3 days. So this is the some technical specification for designing this anaerobic pond. So last one is the storage anaerobic pond. They are used for sewage treatment of wastewater, particularly from sugar mills, starch factories, and distilleries. So these are used for this some industrial wastewater, and the pond should have capacity corresponding to the total production of wastewater. Okay, so you have to design so that you cannot, you should not have to bypass the wastewater without treatment. The storage pond is equipped with a running installation along with even distribution of inflow water. Okay, so even distribution should be there so that you have to proper install this distribution system. Then outflow facility is equipped with a movable discharge device that allows gradual discharge of treated wastewater. Okay, so as the retention time is very high, around 2 to 5 days, so you have to provide a gradual discharge of this treated wastewater from this anaerobic ponds. Okay, then the anaerobic treatment stages are associated with the temperature. So they are very much having a relation with the temperature. At temperature 10 degree below zero, it is very limited. Okay, so anaerobic processes are usually manifested by odor defects that may adversely affect the neighborhood. So as anaerobic treatment releases the odor, So, which will have some make some problem to the nearby residential area, so that we have to look after. And again, it is important to provide the shift in pH of water reaction to slightly alkaline. Okay, if we are having the alkaline pH, then because of this anaerobic plant, degradation of organic matter will be very good in alkaline condition. Okay. So the most important main anaerobic cell treatment processes are they are converting urea to ammonium compounds. Then there is a degradation of proteins to the simple degradation products. Then splitting of fatty acid molecules and significant production of methane. And they are breaking down the cellulose and carbohydrates, and they are reducing the sulfate to hydrogen sulfide, nitrate to nitrite, ammonia to nitrogen gas. So these are the important process of this anaerobic pond. Okay, so next part is of our NBS is aquatic plants for wastewater treatment. Okay, so here you can see the artificial floating wetlands with extensive root system. So these root system are very important part of this treatment system to remove the various pollutant loads. Okay. So here you can see the graphical representation of the cross section of floating wetland. So here the root zones are going root is going deep enough into the water for the removal of some nutrients and some toxic element from this wastewater. Okay. So this aquatic plant treatment system, especially they are including the floating technology. They have been in use for the treatment of this wastewater since several last decades. Just like constructive wetland treatment, it utilizes the principle of natural self-treatment process. Here in constructive wetland, we have seen that what are the vegetations is there, that is very important parameter part of that treatment process. See here also, they are using natural treatment process just like this aquatic plants and floating plants for the removal of the pollutants. This floating treatment wetland can also be compared with the biological ponds. Okay, so it can be just like the biological ponds present in the nature. So we can directly compare it with the biological ponds. The difference is that floating wetland to improve water quality in which they are immersed. Okay, so one thing we have to notice here. So wherever they are immersed, they will improve the water quality in that region only. So that is the difference. Okay, the known use of floating treatment plants can be divided into treatment plants bed and the free floating plants. Okay, so they can be differentiated based on this provision. Okay, so the floating treatment plants differ from constructed wetland with freely floating plants that use a higher emergent plants growing on a floating carrier. Okay, so in constructive wetland we have seen that there is no floating matter, but here we are having the not flowing vegetation, but here in case you can see that we are having the freely floating plants, especially we can call it as the emerging wetland plants on a floating carrier. We are providing some floating carriers as a supporting media in the water, and over that we are providing this plant that emergent wetland plants for the treatment for the good removal of some pollutants. Then this free floating aquatic plants abroad are commonly used to reduce the undissolved and organic matter in sewage and industrial wastewater. So they are good in removal of this organic matter and from in sewage as well as industrial wastewater. And extensive underwater root system. What are the root system are there if they are deep enough into the water, that wastewater, that will provide a large surface area for the growth of these microorganisms. So this microorganism, if they are much more deep enough root system, then the microorganisms will be more, and that will be helpful for the removal of various pollution causing parameters into the wastewater. Okay, so high growth and collection of free floating masses of plants can also be result in significant removal of nutrients and metals. So what are the highly growing plants or the aquatic plants are there? They are good in the removal of nutrients as well as metals from the wastewater. Okay, the water, the plants that should were providing, that should be harvested regularly, because if we are not harvesting, then it will again increase the some pollution load of the water, okay, so which is not desirable and which is not good for the treatment of good removal efficiency of the treatment unit. So we have to keep on harvesting it regularly, because as they are getting much more nutrient in the from the wastewater, the growth of that plants are is very high. So we have to cut down this plants, that leaves of this plant, on a regular basis. Okay, by chemical precipitation and interception of the on the root system, there is also the detention of heavy metals from the present water. Okay, so what are the root system are there? So what the heavy metals get precipitated on that heavy that root zone system. So that is again giving the good removal efficiency in case of this heavy metals. Okay, so use of floating treatment plants is in temperate climatic zone is this plant is because it is a subtropical to the tropical consequently, and it is not resistant to frost. So if you are using it in the country just like Canada, it will not give the good removal efficiency, because as it is the flowing plants, the water, the wastewater is there, that will get frost, or it will be a become icy, so it will not survive there, it will get die, and it will not be a giving the good removal efficiency. So you have to take care that it is mostly provided in the into the region from subtropical to tropical, okay, not in the colder region. The treatment efficiency for the COD has been seen that it is around 32 to 68%. Then for suspended solid removal, it is 66 to 95%, and for total phosphorus removal, it has been seen up to 24 to 61% of this aquatic plant wastewater treatment system. Okay, so coming toward the advantage of this system, so it is aesthetically affecting in case of proper design of the present wetland plants. What are the plants are there? It will give the good aesthetic effect. Again, comparison with the filter technology, it is not prone to environment clogging, as it is not having any filter bed, so it will not get clogged as if we compare it with the constructed wetland. Again, also it captures the insoluble substances with which is in large quantities. Suppose incoming wastewater is having the high quantity of insoluble substances, it will be captured by this floating treatment wetland. It is possible to achieve the significantly better removal of ammonia, nitrate, nitrate and nitrogen from this unit. Okay, also in case of decrease in temperature in winter, so what are the floating plants are there, that they will act as a thermal insulator, so that efficiency of treatment will not be hampered by this temperature change. Okay, again, coming toward the disadvantages, there are some disadvantages of this treatment system also. So when the growing process of the root is not sufficient, the treatment effect is not satisfactory, as it is mostly based on this aquatic plant root zone system. If the roots are not growing properly, then the treatment effect is not that much in that much amount as per the desirable limits. Okay, so in case of the floating plants, the even distribution of plants on the water surface is required. If you are not evenly distributing the plants, then you cannot get the good quality of result of this removal of the wastewater. Removal of the pollutant from the wastewater. Okay. Again, the important thing is that what are the dead parts of the plant, just like leaves and there are some branches, they are getting they are dropping on into the water. That will again causing some organic load of the wastewater. So you have to remove all those dead plants from the wastewater on regular basis. That is very important part. So that is the biggest disadvantage of this treatment unit. Again, during winter, the treatment is get reduced because of the drop in the temperature. That water can get freeze. And because of that, your vegetations will not contribute in the treatment process, and the roots will not help what are the microorganisms which are growing on the roots will not survive into the low temperature zone. So that is a disadvantage, very bigger disadvantage. That's why it is not suggested to use into the regions where very cold regions, especially in Canada and Russia. So that is not recommended. So the need of raking up the bottom to prevent the recontamination of the water by decomposition of the sediments. What are the sediments are there? You have to continuously remove this. Okay, that is a very maintenance part of this treatment, floating treatment wetlands. Okay, so here you can see the again one of the graphical interpretation of your floating wetland. So here is the floating mat. This mat will float over the water, and over this we are going to put over this plants, aquatic plants, and that this roots of this plant will be go deep enough to treat the wastewater. Okay, here you can see the zoom picture of this biofilm which is attached to the root surface. So this is the biofilm which is helping to reduce the potential pollution load of the wastewater. Okay, again in some case you can see the some plant leaves of this plant are submerged into the water. Again on this plant you can see the biofilm attached on the submerged stems and leaves. Okay, so they are helpful into the removal of the pollution load of the wastewater. Okay, so in relatively what are the nutrient poor condition, the water under wetland will be typically have low content of dissolved oxygen. Okay, and which has a very positive effect on the removal of ammonia concentration into the water. Okay, so water, okay, so it is preferable to use them to remove undissolved substances. On other hand, less effective in the removal of dissolved substances. What are the dissolved substances there that will be not removed by this or very less effective in the removal of dissolved substance, but it can be used for the removal of undissolved substances. Then retention of heavy metals by floating wetlands is more efficient than classical constructed wetland. So research has proved that water the heavy metals are present in the wastewater can be removed in much more amount by using this floating wetland as compared to the constructed treatment wetlands. Okay, so next part is the principle of aquatic plant treatment system. So for small natural wastewater treatment plants, for individual dwellings, floating wetland can be used as the output stage in the form of final treatment tanks. Okay, suppose we are having very individual or smaller region, you can use direct as a this final treated tanks. So they provide in addition to improve the water quality by metabolic activity of planktons, mainly planktonic algae and higher aquatic vegetation. Okay, they can also contribute to the elimination of water evaporation from water surface. So the evaporation, because of this evaporation, it will help into the contribution of your water cycle. So depending on the type of aquatic plant, it is possible to distinguish different system such as systems with floating waters. Here you can see the aquatic plant, that is Pistia stachystis, and aquatic plant duckweed lemna. So they are the systems with floating water plants. Okay, so this is the one of the type of aquatic plant. Again, system with submerged aquatic plants, so the Eluda canadensis and demersan and densa, hydrilla, these are the some plants which are used as a submerged aquatic plant in this system. Here you can see the submerged plant. Okay, then system with plants fruiting in the bottom with leaves floating on the surface. Okay, so here you can see the roots are there, roots are deep inside of this water, and the plants and these leaves are on the surface. So it is you might have seen such kind of system in your nearby region also. It is common in our India. So this is the, and this is used as a final treated tanks with the water for the treating the wastewater, and it will also add the aesthetic value to the system as well as the evaporation of the water. Then hydroponic system with algae or cyanobacteria. So So it is the hydroponic system with algae and cyanobacteria. So what are the duckweed is there? It is the from the genus of Lemna and Spirodella, living in the surface water. Okay, so duckweed is generally available or provided into this aquatic plant. So and this system with duckweed are possible to be easily applied in the condition of temperate European climatic zone for the treatment and final treatment of wastewater, because so it is temperature based. So we have to take care of this treatment or application while applying this aquatic plant treatment unit or this temperature. Okay, the use of duckweed for treatment and final treatment of water has many advantages but also limitations. So first we'll see these advantages of this treatment. So it significantly absorbs nutrients from water. Okay, then it is not restricted in its development for lack of light, carbon dioxide. Again, it reproduces very quickly. If get dried, then it will be very quickly reproduced. It can multiply its biomass within 3 to 5 days. So yeah, their biomass is getting multiplied in every 3 to 5 days. And it is very easy to harvest. Then the green matter may be added to the livestock feed rations. They have high nutritional value due to its high protein content, up to 35%. So what are the green matters there? You can use as a livestock feed. Then biomass is suitable for composting. What are the biomass is there that can be used as a compost? Then early development of algae in the water reduces the concentration of non-dissolved substances in the effluent. Okay. So along with that advantages, there are some disadvantages also with this system. The duckweed root system does not provide sufficient substrate for the attachment of microorganism decomposing organic pollution. So that is one of the biggest disadvantages of this system. It is very demanding in the terms of compliance with the harvest mode, because dead matter sinks to the bottom and causes secondary pollution. What are the dead matters from the aquatic plant itself? They are getting sinking into the bottom, and they are again causing some organic load into the water system, water present into the system. So dense continuous growth of duckweed prevents diffusion of oxygen from air to water. What are the diffusion of oxygen is there from air to water? That will be get prevented because of this dense growth. So which prevents photosynthesis, prevents the growth of algae, again prevents the aquatic environment under duckweed becomes to be without oxygen. So that will become an anaerobic zone here. Okay. So then system with submerged aquatic plants, they are immerse plants absorb nutrients from the sediments from the water column. So therefore they are not suitable for water with high content of easily degradable organic matter and are used primarily for further treatment. So these submerged aquatic plants, they are helpful in absorbing the dissolved organic carbon, and it increases the concentration of dissolved oxygen by their own photosynthesis. Then the elevated values of pH create optimum condition for the volatilization of ammonia and phosphorus precipitation. As previously we have seen that in alkaline condition is good for the removal of this ammonia and the phosphorus. So that's why they are good for the removal of this ammonia and phosphorus. They can be classified mainly as the last part of the combined natural system of treatment. Okay. So system with next type is the system with natant aquatic plants. So these systems, for example, with water lilies or some nifer species are in practice in natural wastewater treatment plants used sporadically. But in small natural wastewater treatment plants for individual objects can find a suitable application as a final treating ponds. So actually these are used as a final treatment and removal of this water, the pollution load is there, and they are having the good aesthetic value. And good helpful in the evaporation of your water, so as to maintain the microclimatic condition into the system. Okay, then next part is establishing ponds with floating isolate. So they can be fitted with the different swamp plants with aesthetic appearance, especially yellow iris. This yellow iris is good for the removal of metals. So this is the helpful in the removal of metal present in the wastewater.
and it improves the appearance of significantly contribute to the depletion of nutrients and pollutants. What are the nutrients is there and pollutants are there, that will be significantly removed. Again, water evaporation then provide substrate for microorganism and the roots. Again, provide habitats for the fish, especially in the month of winters, and improve the oxygen balance and enrich the water with oxygen. Okay. And in winter, they prevent the continuous ice cover due to the movement of ice crystals in the wind. Okay, so they are preventing the ice covers into the winter season. If the temperature goes below this 0 degrees Celsius. Okay, then next is the floating plant system. The stabilization plant that especially uses algae and cyanobacteria for treatment of wastewater has been empirically verified in different parts of the world. So water culture with higher plants is also characterized by the ability to remove nutrients and other substances from polluted waters. Okay, so they are having the ability to remove the nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, and the various substances from the polluted waters. And hydroponic culture systems have been developed that can be used for secondary treatment of wastewater and plant production. So generally, it is used for the secondary treatment of the wastewater. And for application of this system, they were to provide check some criteria for the various condition so that we can have a good removal efficiency from the wastewater. So the plant must be highly tolerant to the content of substance in the wastewater and the pH value of water. Okay, so whatever the plants are we are providing, they should be having that capability to sustain themselves into the water, the influent load of the wastewater and the pH value of the water. Then they must the edible portion of the crop must be out of the wastewater and must be adjusted before the consumption. Just like we can use it as a livestock supplement, so what are the edible portion that should be out of the wastewater, so that what are the pollution will be there, that will not be come with that the plants or that edible portion. Okay, so it is possible to use a system with for the growing of tomatoes in wastewater. Yes, the research has been conducted to grow the wastewater, grow the tomatoes in this wastewater, because the tomatoes absorb the large amount of ammonium, nitrogen, potassium from this wastewater. Okay, then paper and sugar beet also successfully grown in the wastewater. Okay, so finally coming toward the end of this presentation, so we'll look toward this advantage of this NBS, nature based solutions. So they are mainly lie in the natural character of the sewage facility, because they are replicated from the nature itself, and they are providing the favorable environment in relatively simple technological implementation. We don't need to go for some complex technology. We can provide a very simple technology for the removal of the wastewater. Then it has a very low operational cost, low investment cost, comparable with the conventional wastewater treatment plant. Again, the low consumption of energy is there in this system. Then it have rapid incorporation of the treatment process. We can rapidly implement this treatment process without taking much more time. Okay, achievement of the performance efficiency of the quality target is in a short period of time after the start of operation. What are the start of operation is there, it will achieve the much more removal efficiency in the very short duration. So it does not require much more time, just like that of the conventional treatment plant, wastewater treatment plant. Okay, so removal of nutrients, especially nitrogen and phosphorus, is very good in case of NBS. Then treatment of organically low loaded wastewater that cannot be treated by conventional methods, we can treat by this NBS. At irrigation by treated wastewater, the economic effect is based on the use of water and fertilizer value of the wastewater. So you can apply this treated wastewater as a irrigation for the irrigation purpose, because whatever the pollution load of this wastewater, treated wastewater, just like nitrogen content, phosphorus content, potassium content, that will give improvement to the soil fertility, and by increasing the crop yields with this treated wastewater through this NBS system. Okay, then limitations of the system, they are not designed treatment of the as a primary treatment unit, because it may get clogged easily, clog, and it may get filled in the initial stages. So we have to provide the pre-treatment of this wastewater for the treating of wastewater through this NBS system. Important and very biggest limitation of this NBS is it requires relatively high area as compared to the conventional treatment unit. But if we go towards the use of this barren land or infertile land, so we can cannot say it as a limitation. So we are using the that land which is infertile for the treatment of wastewater. Then it is having low ammonia nitrogen removal in case of classical arrangement in the anaerobic filtration environment. Okay, so if such kind of environment is developed, so the ammonia removal will be very less in case of this NBS system. So this is the limitation of NBS. So with this, I end my presentation on this natural based solution for the wastewater treatment. So here are some references. So thank you for patiently listening to this session. If you are having any question, you can ask.
If participant have any question, they can ask. Okay, meanwhile I will ask more question.
Yeah,
is this process provide continuous treatment for water?
Yeah, you can use as a continuous treatment, but provided that you have to think about the pre-treatment of the wastewater so that it should not induce the sludge or some solid particles, so that it will get clogged in the initial phase. So you have to think about that part. Yes. Any other questions from participants?
And what about cost?
Cost is very less because you don't require any kind of mechanical arrangement. So you don't require the chemicals. You don't require the electricity. So the cost is drastically reduced. Only you have to bring some that locally available material that will have some costing, but remaining it will not have some major effect on your costing part.
Okay. Okay. No question. Thank you, Atul sir. The lecture was very informative. One more thing, I would like to highlight here that he took the responsibility to make the content available online on YouTube.
Yeah, yeah.
So from his busy schedule, he is doing for us. So thanks for that. And again, thanks for accepting our invitation. Thank you.
Thank you, Aditya sir. And I'm very much thankful to the Dr. M.L. Vikas sir and Dr. Aditya for giving me chance to present my knowledge and sharing my knowledge with you people. And being a part of this session, I am feeling very proud, and I was very enthusiastic to present my lecture here. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, bye.
So can I leave?
Yes, sure.
Okay, thank you.